You seriously mad because we cleaned off your sidewalk? Your sidewalk? So you mad because we cleaned off your sidewalk?
Don't trespass that line. I don't need to.
We're helping you. We're like, you mad because we cleaned off your sidewalk?
Mess around with this one. You know what?
We cleaned off your sidewalk. It's a public sidewalk. We cleaned it off for you.
With Jelly. There. Jelly and Tanya.
Hey,
are you that upset?
What would Jesus do? If you're a real Christian, you have to be.
I don't know. Call
the police.
Yes, I will.
So you calling? What are you calling the police for?
That's trespassing property.
Put them on speaker.
This is the sidewalk. This is a public sidewalk.
Put them on speaker.
This is a public sidewalk, ma'am. I don't know if you own this home, but it's a public sidewalk.
Is this neighbor here, Jay?
Yeah.
And somebody else that I don't know?
Uh-huh.
Bothering me and...
Tell them what we did.
Huh?
Tell them what we did.
No, don't say it, Anja. They'll come faster if you say it's too
it's
over here.
It's a house, sir. I don't want to make him a problem. I give him time. He's taking a movie, taking pictures, someone that I don't know, someone that just came to help his friend.
To do the driveway, to shovel the driveway in a public sidewalk.
It's no weapon that I know, no.
No, what? Oh, they do we have a weapon?
Excuse me?
Leave it alone, Joe, leave it alone. Don't say nothing.
Just... See, they don't have no respect. And I am
Black people don't have respect
that.
Now.
Don't respect, but I plowed her. In front of our house for free.
For free.
Didn't ask her for nothing.
And the police arrived. Here it is.
You see this line?
Yeah.
You don't pass this line.
Okay.
And mm-hmm. I don't want to see you in my, you particular, what is your name? I don't know who you are.
Gregorio.
So go.
Gregorio.
Where you belong?
I know this is my friend's driveway. His dad owned this house. So I'm okay to be on the driveway. We just did his driveway.
I don't know who owned that house any longer, and I don't want to argue with you.
Okay. You have a good day.
You go, because you don't know me.
Okay. I don't.
Are you threatening her?
No. Leave it on, Jay. Let her put the snow back on the sidewalk.
Hey, you get snow on my side.
You don't got no side. You need somebody else. Go with Jelly. I apologize to you, and I am sorry. Okay,
are you going to be sorry after you call the police?
Sorry that I say that name. Because you know what? I don't want anything to do with there or what happened. That is your business.
What you talking about?
You have somebody from your family. What would you have them do to us?
What they going to do?
Take that devil out of my face.
What they going to do? Are you threatening me? Are you saying that they going to kill me?
You can call anybody out of your family.
I hear Tanya.
I'm saying, are you threatening me? No, I'm asking you a question. Are you threatening me?
You're damn right. I want her arrested. I'm in fear of my life, damn it. That's what I would have told her. You know how many elderly black women and elderly black men they arrest? You know, we covered a story right here on Indisputable. They locked up an elderly black woman for not paying her trash bill. This was out of Alabama. She went to jail. Nobody had any sympathy for her. She didn't threaten anybody. Did not even break a law. It was part of some ridiculous private public partnership that created a contempt of court charge for her. They knew she was an elderly black woman and they decided to arrest her because she was late on the trash bill. Sometimes people need to sit down somewhere. I promise you she would have been well protected. All right? It's infuriating because that situation you just witnessed, life or death, situation that could have went totally different. All right, Ben, thoughts here?
Yeah, I mean, what you said just there is like really important because what happens if the police officers show up and they had a bad day, right? What happens? And because I mean, like first and foremost, like I mean, this is just like ridiculous, right? Like depending on what city they're in, like it could actually be illegal to put snow intentionally onto your sidewalk like that after it's been shoveled. You know, you actually have to have like a way for like postal service workers to be able to get to your mailbox. It's like a whole entire thing. You know, not to mention like city ordinances about like making sure that sidewalks are clear for people with like disabilities and stuff like that. So like that's just all like you know, misdemeanor stuff, but also, like, I think important, like, you know, or like civil penalties or whatever for, like, but like the reason why I say that is because somebody's doing you a huge favor. In some places, like, you literally as a property owner have a responsibility legally to keep your sidewalk clear. And so if somebody's clearing your sidewalk for you, they're doing you an act of kindness. But what she said in the middle about, like, oh, how you're not showing me any respect or anything, really speaks to the shamelessness that exists in the United States and just the sheer white supremacy that is deeply embedded within our society, where quite literally there are a lot of folks out there that think that they are, like, just owed, like, an extreme degree of not just respect, but, like, deference, right, for more marginalized people around them. And that is what, like, creates all of these situations in the first place. Just this presupposition that if you are in any way, shape, or form privileged, that marginalized people around you should always be thinking about and anticipating your mind, like, your needs, and, like, reading your mind about what you might possibly want in every given situation. Whereas, like, if you're a privileged person, you're never expected to, like, think about, like, or anticipate, like, the thoughts, feelings, and needs of more marginalized people around you. And that creates this imbalance of understanding where, like, let's be real, if the police officers offered to have those two men arrested, do you think that she would show them the same kindness that they showed her? I don't think that would happen. And so, like, fundamentally, it's just this problem that's, like, deeply embedded with our society. And, like, I don't know, you have to be really, really shameless to, like, get angry at somebody for, like, shoveling the snow off of your sidewalk. And it's just, like,
a lot of hate in your heart. Hats off to the gentleman who kept it classy. All right. Got a lot of respect for you guys.